in what I want. I've never written down what my vision is, what I want. I grew up in a family with very difficult relationships. My parents are divorced. My mother and stepfather have a great relationship. I didn't have any role models. I saw certain things that I internalized in the way they related, and I really had a set of beliefs and behaviors around relationships that were, am I doing? That I chose the people I chose. I did the things I did to make them not great. Or, you know, so I was really, you know, driven by some of my own beliefs and attitudes. And when I sat down, everyone, I was like, no, I need to sit down and write down what I want for a relationship. And I wrote it all down in great detail, like really great detail. And it's like 2 full pages of content. And at that moment is when I opened the door for having the greatest love I've ever known, which is my wife. And I would never be able to get that unless I named it. Yeah. Right? So this is what you take people through each category.
In every category of your life.
Yeah.
There's a magic to doing that. We're not even sure exactly what that mechanism is. It's part spiritual, it's part physical. There's a magic to getting crystal clear on the person you want to become and the life you want to live. What you tend to do is you tend to let everything else kind of fall away. I mean, once you really discover that, you tend to focus on that. And that tends to become a self-fulfilling prophecy. Your daily choices and actions start to align with it. The things that don't vibrate with it start to fall away. And eventually, if you do it right, getting crystal clarity on the life that you want to live and really keeping it in the forefront of your mind, making your choices and actions based on it, you will wake up one day and look around and say, geez, what used to be a vision is now my reality.
Yeah, well,
that's right. And I personally think that this is how we're wired. Like, human beings are supposed to do this. We're supposed to self-actualize. We're here, right? But our culture's gotten to a point where there's so many distractions and we're covered up. Like,
yeah,
we're
talking about.
Yeah, none of that. We're completely, and there's no role models. I mean, like, you brought up a good point. I had really good role models. My parents were in a loving relationship. My parents, so that was lucky that we had that. But there aren't really a lot of role models.
Let me just say this real quick about role models, though, because my role models actually came from history and literature.
Yeah.
So and that's a thing. That's a real thing. One of the things we talk about in my book in the social category is if you're not surrounded by good role models, you go out there and find them by reading history.
That's true.
Great men and great women of history that inspire you and that you admire, and why and how can you be more like that? So everyone can have good role models, but some of us have to do some work.
Yeah. You
know,
it's true. I found the same thing through biographies.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
It's a great resource.
Yeah. Yeah. Understanding, you know, and people look at even if those lives often they weren't coherent. In other words, it's like Einstein. Good guy, had a tremendous contribution. He had a beautiful sense of life and spirituality. He, you know, discovered theory of relativity and quantum physics. He changed everything about the world we know. But his personal life was a shambles.
Yeah,
you know,
that's true.
Even Gandhi, Gandhi had regrets at the end of his life for not being the parent that he wished to be, you know, to his son. That's a famous story, too. That's one of the things that Life Book creates. And again, I feel like, you know, we're so grateful to live in the best time and place in all of human history that made it possible for us to even conceive. How can we create an extraordinary life in every important area? And then once we did conceive that, the resources we needed to do that were absolutely out there. It was just a matter of pulling it all together in one strategy. The good news is, LifeBook literally is a system that is completely ready-made for you. All you gotta do is sit down, you know, Mark, sit down and do
it. It's open source. Yes, that's right.
And at the end of that process, you will create something extraordinary.
Yeah, I'm a trillion person, which is powerful.
Yeah.
But now you have it online, yeah.
And that's powerful too, because it allows us to put through a bit of time while we're all sharing with each other. And the difference between live and online, live is awesome because it happens in 4 days, like a there's something about that.
It's all you do, every day, all day.
Online is awesome because you're doing 2 categories a week and you can really think about those categories while they're happening and interact with the people that are going through it. So they're both really interesting experiences and they're both transformative. Everyone that goes through it does this work because you can bring as much consciousness to your life all at once and not completely transform.
Those topics that group, they're really extraordinary people, very successful business people, leaders in their fields, creative people. I mean, people really, they gather stuff together. And yet, probably in some areas, other areas were just not the best. And to go through that with these people and sort of see them really, start to look at themselves in ways they never thought, start to question their beliefs, start to imagine their lives in ways that they hadn't imagined before. It's really powerful. It's really powerful. And you think, oh, these two have their life together. And I'm like, okay, I'm pretty generally happy. Like, I have a great marriage, I have a great conscience, I have a great attention. I really, you know, love my life. But I also realize that, you know, despite all my successes, there were areas that I really hadn't fully taken on and owned and responsible for the choices that I'm making, or the beliefs that I had. So, no, I can't have this, or I can't have that. And it's not about having, you know, all this in the material sense. It's about, you know, having life fulfilling. And how do you get to that place of being filled up, living on purpose, feeling alive, and contributing. So, and you can say it's a very narcissistic process. You're just looking at what you want in your life. It turns out the opposite. You know, what happens in the process of healing yourself is that you become a contribution to the world.
That's right.
There's many different ways you don't have. You've got to start with yourself. If every one of us did that, the world would be a whole lot better place.
So by actually working on creating a healthy you from the inside out,
you're doing the best work you're going to be doing.
You are, and you're also going to enhance the lives of the friends you have, your family, your children, your community, and even you step further beyond that. You have what you need to do to all these other contributions to helping with addiction, to help tragic orphans, to help, you know, reduce community farms, and people with some charity coffee with some of your puppies. There's just so much that can happen if you actually do that work on yourself.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, that's the key. We did this. We had this life book for 15 years. It took us that long to create that life for ourselves, and then we realized, oh my gosh, we could show some with other people. They could do the same thing. There's nothing special about us.
No, I would disagree.
And it's not that we did this system.
Yeah.
It's a
structure.
Yes.
And I'm not going to be 60 this year. I've never really had anybody walk me through in that way, in my thinking, what my vision is, what my purpose is for wanting these things.
Can you imagine if I was in our 20s, Mark?
I know,
I would say these
stories.
That's
quite
true.
One of the areas I was in a relationship where after like 6 months or 8 months, whatever it was, my partner said, well, you know, it was just, we had a little spat. She's like, that's just the honeymoon period. It's over now. We have to deal with real life. I was like, what? And I'm like, wow, that was a lady.
So she had this like inspiration date.
Yeah.
showing up from an emotional, intellectual, spiritual perspective, you know, really thinking through the life that you want to have 5 years from now, and one of the reasons that can be so incredibly powerful for a couple is because if that's your North Star, that can help you get through so much of the little crap that can knock couples. You're both working to something incredibly important.
And all the insignificant stuff, really insignificant.
So that's why sacrifices sometimes have to be made in order to turn, you know, your life into something great, but we know where we're going, and we know it's going to be work, and we're up to this task, and some days are going to be harder than others. We're going to have our victories and our failures on the way to that, but we know where we're going as a couple. This is where our energy is going, and that's magic.
Alright, so people are listening to this podcast and wondering, wow, maybe I should think about having a vision for my life. maybe I can have the dreams that I want to have. Maybe I can be a better contribution. Maybe I can be more fulfilled. Maybe I don't have to just accept all of my beliefs. Maybe I can design a life where I can thrive, my family can thrive, and I can have a strong relationship, make a career. It's not beyond reach, which it is. So that is the question I often wonder when I saw very successful people. How do they do it? What do they do? How do they work? What's your story? And the good news here is that you and Missy have run this extraordinary program, which is Lifebook Online. Life that didn't follow in the guardrails we all think we have to follow, and created this program for us all to learn from and to grow from and to be empowered by. So it's a huge gift to the world. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Mark.
Thank you, Mark. Thank you, Mark. Thank you, Mark. Thank you, Mark. Thank you, Mark. Thank you, Mark. Thank you, Mark. Thank you, Mark. Thank you, Mark. Thank you, Mark. Thank you, Mark. Thank you, Mark. Thank you, Mark. Thank you, Mark. Thank you, Mark. Thank you, Mark. Thank you, Mark. Thank you, Mark. Thank you, Mark. And if you love this podcast, please share with friends and family on social media. If you like it, please leave a review. We'd love to hear from you. And you can subscribe anywhere you get podcasts, iTunes, Google Play, etc. And we'll see you next week on the Dr. Trumpsy.
Stem cells that come from people's own bodies, not some other stem cells from another person. And he's a mentor, so they call the full body stem.
systems don't take over. It's found that the Sarah Clinic is located in beautiful Park City, which is where we are right now. And I'm about to go under anesthesia and get all this stuff done to me, so I'm very excited about it. Dr. Killen, sitting next to me here, is a national recognized anti-aging and regenerative physician specializing in aesthetics and sexual optimization. We're going to talk about